Michelle Glass here, and welcome back to our Biology 2010 Anatomy and Physiology Lab recordings. We are focusing in this presentation on our connective tissues. Now, the connective tissues are a bigger group than what we had in the epithelial tissues. I will be talking about 10 connective tissues in this presentation. Now, connective tissues don't look so much like a group the way the epithelial tissues do, but the connective tissues do have in common that you have what is described as a specialized cell, and there are several different types of cells, and I'll be pointing out some examples of these as we go along. And these are located in what is referred to as a ground matrix. Now, the ground matrix is something that's been secreted by those specialized cells. And so one of the key components we're going to be seeing are what are described as extracellular. So this extra prefix means outside of the cell, fibers. Extracellular fibers are proteins. Now, we're going to be looking at several different types of fibers. I'll mention these as we go through. So we're going to be looking at collagen fibers for strength. We're going to be looking at elastic fibers, which are stretchy. And we're going to be looking at reticular fibers, which think about those as scaffolding. As we go through our connective tissues, they quite literally connect the body together. So connective tissues include tissues such as bone and cartilage. Your ligaments and tendons are composed of connective tissue. Your blood is composed of connective tissue. Connective tissue is making the framework of the body. Connective tissue is padding and filling spaces in between epithelial tissue and muscle tissue. And in terms of the blood, it is connecting the body together by transporting chemicals and nutrients and waste and gases from one part of the body to the next. So I like to use the summary function for all of these as structural support. The first of the connective tissues that we're looking at is called areolar tissue. And so this is kind of our generic loose connective tissue. You have all of the different types of fibers in this tissue and lots of different types of specialized cells. I really like showing this slide at the 100x magnification. Once it gets to the 400 times magnified, it begins difficult to get everything in focus on the microscope. To some extent, I've had students describe this as like spaghetti and meatballs, so if that helps you to identify it. Areolar tissue is going to be widespread throughout the body, so we'll see this lots and lots of different places. One place that's probably good to memorize at this point would be the dermis. So the dermis is one of your layers of the skin. The next connective tissue that we're going to be looking at is the adipose tissue. This is our fat storage tissue. So this is composed of these adipocytes, which are the fat cells that are storing the fat. So what you're seeing here is the cell membrane and all of its contents, including its nucleus, are getting squished to the edge to make room for all of that triglyceride molecule. Here, again, this is another slide. I really like to focus in on the 100 times magnified rather than the 400 times. Again, our generic function structural support can be applied here, but you can also talk about fat storage. Fat is an energy molecule, so storage of energy. Insulation and padding are also jobs of adipose tissue. You will see this lots of places throughout the body, padding key organs. You have some padding the eyeball and the eye socket, positioned around the kidneys, the heart. You also have a layer of fat called the subcutaneous layer, so that's going to be a good location to memorize this semester. Your reticular tissue is another type of loose connective tissue. You're seeing here your reticulocytes and your reticular fiber. Reticular fibers are making a scaffolding, so you will see reticular tissue in those organs that are very thick and fibrous but don't have a lot of muscle. So the location I like to memorize here is the liver. Your dense regular connective tissue, you can see, is dominated by collagen fibers. You have few, if any, visible cells. So you're seeing basically your fibers are running in a parallel direction throughout the whole screen here. Our ligaments and tendons are composed of dense regular connective tissue. Tendons and ligaments are also composed of the elastic tissue, and here you will see visible cells, so that's going to be a really good way to help differentiate between these two tissues. There's a little bit more of a curvature to these fibers, as these are the elastic fibers, so they have a little bit of a stretchiness to them. I like to think about sort of a relaxed rubber band. The next tissue to look at is the compact bone tissue. So this is the tissue that is found in your skeleton. Your compact bone is characterized by these concentric rings, which are called osteons. So you have at the center of each what's called a central canal. This is going to hold your blood vessels, because remember, this is living tissue. And then you're going to have your specialized cells called osteocytes in these rings around the central canal. And so you have these little caniculi that connect the cells to that central canal. So that's how you're getting this very precise kind of arrangement. For me, the compact bone is easy for me to memorize because it looks like tree stumps. So that's how I remember this one. We have three different types of cartilage tissues to look at. The cartilage tissue for me was always easy because you have these kind of open spaces. You have a cell that's located inside that open space, and then you have this smooth matrix on the outside. And so that kind of appearance was always easy for me to see and recognize that it's cartilage. It's a little bit harder to figure out which type of cartilage you're looking at. This cartilage here is called hyaline cartilage. It has no visible fibers in the matrix, and so that's why it's this lightly stained purple color. The stain for the cartilages is going to really adhere to those fibers. So the more fibers you have, the darker purple the stain will be. Because your hyaline cartilage has this very light lavender color, that tells us that there's very few fibers present. Also, look at this distribution of the cells. These little pockets that I was referring to are called lacun A. AE ending is plural. I'm pointing here to a single lacuna. These are those little pockets. And then those cells that are here are called chondrocytes, where the prefix chondro means cartilage, and that ending C-Y-T-E means cell. So look at the arrangement here of the chondrocytes and the lacunae, and we'll see a difference as we look at the other types of cartilages. Hyaline cartilage is the cartilage that's really found in your skeleton. So this is the cartilage that is found between your ribs and your sternum. Those are called costal cartilages. This is the cartilage that's found in your synovial or movable joints. So that's going to be another good location here. The elastic cartilage, notice you can still see those lacunae with those chondrocytes, but there's a lot more of them, and they're very densely packed together. Notice how darkly purple this slide is. And remember, that tells us that there are more fibers. And it's a little bit tricky to see the fibers in this picture, but they're kind of spread throughout like this. The elastic fiber is going to be found in the cartilage of your ear. So you're going to see it there. This last one can be called either fibrocartilage as one word or fibrous cartilage as two. Now this is the area that I like to zoom in. Notice you still have your chondrocytes and your located in your lacunae. They're kind of in these little pockets or collections. And then in the background here in the matrix, it's a much darker purple. And if you look carefully, you can kind of see it looks maybe like brush strokes in these areas that I've circled to help you see what might be your fibers. You see that there? The dark color stain, the arrangement of the chondrocytes and the lacunae can all be clues that you're looking at fibrocartilage. Fibrocartilage is going to be located in a couple of places. One is called the pubic symphysis. So this is a pad of cartilage that you have between your pubic bones. And also the intervertebral disc. Make sure I didn't miss something. All right. The last one for us to look at here is blood. So blood is a connective tissue. The difference here is those fibers, those proteins are not fibers. Instead, they're the globular shaped protein. So they're suspended as a liquid. Now what you're looking at here are your red blood cells. And this is a white blood cell. So those are specialized cells. Your matrix here is that plasma. And so it's not something that's really visible under the microscope, but it is an important matrix. Your blood is found in the cardiovascular system. So it's always in the heart or the blood vessels. If it is outside of the cardiovascular system, then that's what we call bleeding. So saying that blood is everywhere is not a good thing. The blood is, of course, involved in supporting the body because it is transporting nutrients and gases and waste products throughout the body. And that completes us on the connective tissue.